Hello, my name is Creo Sticks, and welcome back to The Evil Within, where our safe room is crumbling by the minute. At least that's what it feels like. I'm not 100% sure, but it feels like it's just getting worse. Like, this crumbling wasn't that, like, noisy and all that, like, the last few times I was here. Man. Oh well. But let's return to the scary apartment building thing place where... Actually, I didn't actually enter this room. I was teleported, like, through the door, I guess, but that's fine. Yep, and I still don't have quite 25,000, so let's not go back. I'm annoyingly close, but... Oh, what? That door was locked a moment ago. I wonder if there's something to get here before I go, just, you know. It wouldn't be the first time the game sort of tricks me out of getting stuff. But this looks okay. That is a creepy painting man. I think I saw a similar one a while back in, like, the last episode. I didn't comment on it, but yeah, I remember that one. Nothing to press there on the elevator. I guess we're fine then. Okay, I think that's... Yep. And more... I am fucking stocked with parts. Like, this feels nice to have so many building parts. That I have, like, harpoons for days if I need to. Oh. And healing items. And sludge. Good. And more parts. This is... It's almost like they're preparing me for something. And, yeah, I'm getting 25,000 almost just after I can't anymore get back there, which, you know, that's... Oh, okay. I hear growling again. What are you doing? What? Is that like a zombie with bombs on it, or what's the deal? Is there anything else here? Oh, hi! Paid to be careful, man. Woo! I'm onto you, you see. But, yeah, that... If we have kamikaze zombies, that's... Ooh! That is a nasty, nasty way to do business. Just saying. Okay, nothing here. Just, you know, had to check. Let me zoom in just a bit. Oh no. At first I thought they looked like explosive bolts, but... Nah, it's like spiky... mines? On him? Yeah, I'm not getting close to that. Like, not even sneaking. I'm not gonna take that chance. Like, I... Yep. That was... Oh, fuck. Nope. Hoo-ha. Well, that went well. That went surprisingly okay. Okay, good. We're Doing fine. That looks like a big room. Huh. Oh. Okay. Well, sure. Great. Yeah. Well, fine. That's good. Map fragments. Great. And more of these. 60 trap parts. Those I have a lot of these days. And 25,000 now. Yep. I would love to have a save room again, because now I have enough to do the life upgrade, you know? Okay, anything... Huh, there's a lot of these... I can't press the vending machine, no? Huh. Oh right, the eye is like the spike. Oh, I didn't even see that before. Oh well. Okay, sure, and then just get items, get more sludge, and again, it's already, it's a thing that already has been, you know. Yeah, that's, that is a sight, for sure. Oh well. Okay. Seriously, I feel like they're preparing me for something, because that's a lot of sludge, and more importantly, I've had parts for days. Okay, right, I might actually want to use a lantern a bit. Oh. Well, the more you learn. Now I know I can't disarm those, so that's great. Or at least, well, I didn't try to like push my face into it before it exploded. That's true, but I'm not gonna go trying that now. And take the sludge. That's actually, I got a feeling it wasn't gonna be there for very long. And there's that. Okay, good. Good. Excellent. So, any surprises here? No. Again, I kind of feel like the keeper. Where are you, man? Okay. I hope I didn't miss anything there, because I got a feeling I can't go back. Well, I'm sure I did miss something, but you know that's, you know that's life. At least that is this game. Oh man. Oh, but it's empty. Okay. But there's something. Oh, that's not empty. Brain sludge for everyone. Oh, a box. With nothing in it, but, well, that's... Oh, wait. That's a dead end. Oh, right, I need to go here. Sure.
Joseph?
Right? Or Kidman? Or... Well, I mean, I don't think there's a whole lot of other options. I mean, I don't think I've seen a Leslie, like, use a... I mean, if that was a gunshot. I'm not actually sure if it was a gunshot, though. So, gel, some, whatever that is, anything here? Oh, the lighting is pretty good, Nope, can't press buttons, like, I see a button, I'm gonna try it, because there was that one elevator that had the statue in it, so I'm just, you know, just trying to be thorough, and doing my best not to miss at least some of them, you know? I feel like I've been surprisingly almost okay about them, but I've still probably missed almost a third or half or whatever. That is a floating rat. A rat person. Rat, you need to teach that to me. I want to fly away from here too, to meet Ruvik in very fast succession in the mental hospital and get into the real world and save myself and my friends and the world, maybe, and... Well, I mean, maybe the world isn't in peril, I guess. Maybe, but... Oh, well. Then again, I don't know if... Intestines and... Joseph, hi! Do you wanna... come here and say hello? Oh crap, doof, ow. Hi. Okay.
Oh god, now what?
Good question. Just when I thought things couldn't get any creepier. So, well, let's take it slow, I guess. But I got a feeling there's gonna be something else than just, you know, dark rooms and red lights when, you know, shit goes down. I got a feeling it's gonna be more than that. Okay, what? Lightning, or well, you know, electricity bolt. What? Roombas? Oh, what? Yeah, I got the... Oh, that's okay, so... Oh, don't be mad. I just gonna take the key and... Oh, that's a fire. But yeah, I figured that I can like... Ow. Go away from the fire, asshole. Yeah. Oh, don't burn, just take it easy. Oh, that's a... Oh! Ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha! At least I didn't miss... Oh! I didn't miss, trap part, because apparently I could get that from those. Oh, right. And, actually, before I go forward, let's just... Because I got the hint, yeah? If I get a electricity bolt, I should maybe equip that. Oh, come on. There we go. Oh! Ah! Well, that went badly, then. I know. My health was low. That was a tactical choice, sort of. Like, my thought process was that if I would be able to get with my lower health into a save point and then upgrade, I wouldn't have to use one. But yeah, that's like, I know. It was risky and it didn't pay off this time. But well, you know. So, but let's just do it again. Now we have a better idea of what we're looking at, like trip wires and. Although, I'm not quite sure, like, did the Roomba explode? And why didn't they explode before? That's my kind of a question here, but, okay, just, you know, again, take that, come on, and... Yeah, let's do this. Go through here, and there was this trip wire. There we go. Ow! Again, now it's not exploding on me. Why? Anything in here? Nope. Doop ba doop up, doop ba doop up, doop ba doop up, doop ba doop boop doop boop doop. This is. So hi! That's great! I got lucky there, I think. Oh, there too. And, yep. Are we good? Are we okay? Oh. Anything here? Ow. Oh, that is tricky. I just saw that. Oh. You are a tricky one. You almost exploded on me. Like, some of the Roombas explode and some of them don't. That's... But I guess I made it. Can I just... I would love to, like, close the door, you know? Hold on, is that a... That's a dead body. Anything... Like, my next question is, which way do I go? And if I go one way, does it, like, lock me out of another way? I think Joseph ran that way, though, so let's... I think. I hope? So I... So this is maybe the extra items place? Yes, question mark? Or is there anything in here? Oh! Sludge and shotgun shells. That is... Excuse me. Man. Throat right like a blah. Not cutting, man. This is a raw, like a raw let's play, you see. I'll try always not to cut unless there's like something really like, you know, distracting, like, you know, just if a phone rings or whatever, you know. That's that sort of thing. It creates, let's say, a realistic environment. Okay, so. Man, that felt weird. Okay. Here we go. Oh. Oh, well, that's... You made it. Good. Will I make it now? Oh fuck. Oh.
You again?
My thoughts exactly. What am I? Oh. Do I go there too? Ah, come on. I know this is risky, but I gotta give it a go. Oops. Oops. Oops, well, risk didn't pay off. Sure, that's fair enough, fair enough, fair enough. Yep. That is, not very, very, cinematic, because it's hard to see what happened. I'm not sure, but, yeah. Oh, well. I mean, yeah, I know it was like the most foolhardy risk ever taken. I know, but, you know, I noticed that the checkpoint was right here, so I was like, well, I might ever, might as well, you know. Like, who almost cares? Like, I'm gonna die anywhere at least once in this spot. And again, like, do I need to shoot at you? Like, my first guess is no, but what do I do? Where do I go? Do I go somewhere? Or do I... Is this the arena to now kill you? Or... they do give me ammo, though. Huh. I mean, this is exactly what I mean. Like, how am I supposed to know if I need to use my few bullets on you? How? And that is really a problem in game design. That is a bad way to do it. That just is a bad way to do it. I'm telling you, that's not good. And that, like, again, it's... And when I see a problem like this, it diminishes your scare factor. Like, now you're just a wall of ones and zeros, which is just not very well utilized. So, like, Joseph went here. Fine! I'll just shoot at you then. Whatever. I guess that's what we're supposed to do now. I mean, come on, like, that's not... God, you need to use your enemies better. Like, make them make sense. Like, even in horror, things need to follow their own logic, and this doesn't sometimes. That's so annoying with this and some of these enemies. Yep, and now I take all of my shotguns at you. Oh! Okay. What? Oh. So now you are immortal anyway, so I... wasted my ammo? Question mark? I mean, I guess it still follows sort of the logic that it's usually immortal, sure, but... I'm not, Hi, yeah. So I can't kill you then? Which I guess that sort of follows what we have been doing for now, but what am I supposed to do? Just... yeah. And yeah, like, this is kind of like the... I was afraid of something like this. Like an unclear boss fight? Question mark? Do I need to leave the door? No, it's locked. Yeah, now I'm dead. That's yeah, but like that's... huh. So... so here's the question, like... No, just give me just a second here. So like, this is pretty much exactly what I was afraid of. Like, an unclear boss fight-ish room where I get a bunch of ammo telling me that I guess I need to fight it, but then I don't because it's again immortal. So, but I can't leave the room. I think. I mean, I've waited for quite a while around the room. Like, I don't think it's gonna happen, like, in a time limit or something. Or if it does, it's, like, fucking 10 minutes or something. So... now I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Another question is, do I bang my head against this for God knows how many times now, then? Or do I give up and look up, like, what am I supposed to do here? Like, what is the best thing? Like, I'm not actually sure, because what is the best thing for the viewer, like you? Like, what do you want to see when this happens? I don't know. I'm not sure. Like, what is more entertaining to watch? Like, watch me die over and over again to this and not know what I'm supposed to do? Or what? Like, I guess I'll just then, like... kill him over and over and over and over again and see if that does something, but that's like the only thing I can think of. And if that wastes all my ammo, the game's over, I guess, but whatever. I don't know, man. Like, this is exactly what I'm talking about. And just saying, if it eventually... oh, and Flash Bolt doesn't work for you. Well, now I know that thing too. That's okay. So I liked what the Freeze Bolt did to you. That's something. So, you know. Oh. I think I'm dead already, though, so, you know. Oh, well. That happened, too. So, yeah. I don't want to, like, you know, I know I have a semi-low amount of health, but I didn't want to... I mean, I'm against using them unless I have to. That's just my own, like, being stingy, but, you know, okay. So let's just kill you until you don't move. And again, the crossbow is weird. I know, I just, like, I chose the freeze bolts in the inventory, but it still took the flash bolts. Why? I don't know. Like, I'm not even really frustrated at this point. I'm just, like, disappointed. Like, this is what I was afraid of, and this is not good. This is not a good spot, like, especially, like, if the answer is just kill it a lot of times, then it's really bad, because that breaks the logic completely. Like, you put an immortal enemy, and if the answer is just kill it a lot of times, then that's really bad. Like, that just doesn't follow a logic at all. And that breaks its own rules in the video game, which is really just... That's not good design. Like, I'm sorry, but that is not. Like, again, good game, but this is a bad spot if that's what it is. So, let's see. Again, freeze your ass. Yeah, I know. I know. There you go. And let's use a bunch of these. Alright. Two sniper bullets. Good. Any more? A third one? Or, well, the third of the same one? Beep, beep, beep happened somewhere, so there's that. Oh, so... Yeah, I know I maybe, like, left a couple of sludges or items there, but yeah, sure, but I'm going if that's the... Like, yeah, that's... I simply disagree with that. Like, that was not a time limit. That was not a time...
God damn it.
Yeah. Mm-mm, no. No. Like,
fuck.
Like, here's the thing. You need to have, like, when you have bosses, have them, like, be consistent. Like, I've said this a couple of times, but I want to, like, make sure that everyone, like, understands what I mean here. Like, when you have a boss, have it be consistent in what it is. If you have a boss which is just escape this boss, then have that boss be only that. Always escape that boss, you know? Or maybe, just maybe, have at the very end one spot where you need to actually fight and kill it. Like, again, the Laura example. It was first escape that boss, and then it was kill that boss. If it would have ended there, that would have been a little, but that would have been sort of fine. But then, after that, Laura happened again. And then it was, escape this boss again and don't fight it. I mean, okay, I don't know for a fact if, like, using every single bullet ever in the world would have killed her, fine. But the, like, the design of the moment, the story, the, you know, reach the elevator and then she hugs you, you know, that was escape this boss moment, right? So it was one thing first, a second thing then, and one thing after that again. So it's like... It wasn't consistent. And now this keeper dude. Like, the first thing I see him is, hi, you're a badass thing, which I had to kill. So first it was kill him to open a door, right? And then I had to, like, avoid him because he was immortal. So now escape from him then. Okay. And then there was a cutscene where I put him under spikes and then dead. So then again, kill him. So kill him, avoid him, kill him. And in the corridors where he was like stalking me, but we didn't fight before that, then it was like avoid him again. So kill him, avoid him, kill him, avoid him. That's four already. And then that, where that was not a time limit. That was he's immortal, but kill him twice. That's like a fifth different thing. Like, one thing, second thing, one thing, second thing, one thing, second thing. Which thing am I supposed to do when I meet that boss? And that is inconsistent all the time. And that's not okay. That is not a good way to design a game. It's like almost... Wait. Wow. Oh, man. Do I get the key? There we go. Right? So, it's like if you're playing, like, Civilization, and at random intervals the end turn button just closes the game or something. It's like, the things in your game need to do the same thing every time, at least more or less. Like, I know some examples can be different a little bit, but you have to have your mechanics be consistent. Like, if I shoot this gun, a bullet comes out. It doesn't all of a sudden change into, it turns into a chicken. And that's what's happening with these bosses. Like, I don't know what to do when I meet one of those bosses. And that's not good. It's like, it's, instead of scary, it becomes just confusing. Like, I'm just a question mark of, okay, what do I do now? What do you expect me to... how do you expect me to react to this time?
I guess she's all right.
Ah.
What's she after?
Well, I mean, she's after Ruvik and Leslie, I think. I mean, at least that's who's with her, right? Sure. But yeah. Anyway, but this is like, it's like a problem in this game. But then again, as I've mentioned many times before, a problem in the game does not mean it's a bad game. But that is a choice that I don't agree with, you know? Oh well. Here we go. Oh, and I need to go to the, I need to find a save room and not use a health item, because that will save me a health item. Okay, let's see here. Anything good? Nope. Okay, and now we are... Oh, a cutscene. Okay, good. Ah, kid. Right.
Leslie can go home. Can take the train all the way home.
Huh?
No, Leslie. Not today.
You'll protect me?
Yes. That's my job.
Good, good, good. When I get home, they'll be surprised.
Ooh. Does that mean Ruvik is somewhere, or what? Or is Leslie doing that? Oh, why? Why?
It's not your fault. I'm sorry.
Stop.
You don't understand. You don't know what he'll become.
I do. I've seen it.
You don't understand what Ruvik is after.
So tell me. What is he after?
He's after Leslie.
Right?
What, he needs to finish his science project?
Don't patronize me. I have orders. I can't let him have this boy. Leslie is the only one he can...
Oh, that's a high-pitched... That's like a Sindel scream right there. Oh! Joseph, no. No. After all this, Kidman shot Joseph. Oh, come on. Oh, that is a cleared chapter. That is awesome. I think I'm gonna go just a little bit further. I'm not quite at the full time yet, so I might as well just keep going just a little, like maybe a 10 minutes or something like that. Or 10 minutes and a bit then. But let's see if we get a good like stopping point. But yeah, but this is not quite that yet. So let's next chapter. But yeah, that's just I hope like people don't like misunderstand me when I keep harping on about the keeper boss, like how I don't like it, how I don't agree with the boss, like how they use it. Like, that's just still it's only one detail of the game. It's not my entire opinion of the game. Still, it's just that one thing is something I don't really agree with. It's again the same thing with the Goomba example. Like, it's like if you would meet once a Goomba which you can jump on, and then next Goomba comes along, which looks exactly the same, is in every way similar, but you jump on that, and you die when you jump on that then. And then the next Goomba you can jump on, and the next one you can't, and then it's just hot and cold and on and off, and you don't know what to do when you see a Goomba all over. Like, that's my problem. Like, I want, like, to have consistency in how to deal with an enemy. Like, that's... And that doesn't come here. That's the problem. Like... But most enemies are fine, though. Like, the zombies. I know how a zombie operates in this game. I know how that weird Ruvik copy more or less works in this game. I know what else is there? Like, how the water monsters operate. I know how all of those work. They all work in the same way, and that's... They're still scary, they're super frightening, they're all that, but they're consistent, and that's what makes them good. That's what I mean. Ooh. But I do like the loading screens. Oh, actually, I think I had a thought, like, before, which was like, stopped, or I got interrupted, like, a couple of episodes ago, actually, about the loading screens. How, I think I'll finish that thought a second later, still, because I want to see what's here, then. In a subway tunnel, maybe? It looks like it.
Joseph, you've got to be alive.
I hope he is. But yeah, ulterior motives, like, about loading screens, like, I think most loading screens are just a static screen with, like, nothing moving in them, because until, like, I think, like, about a bit over a year ago or something, Namco Bandai had the patent for interactive loading screens, which meant, like, if you made a loading screen where you could actually, like, do stuff, like move or such, like you can in, say, Bayonetta, you can move and do combos and practice. If you did something like that, anything like that with an interactive loading screen, then you have to pay Namco Bandai money because they own the patent to it. But I think it had expired at this point, so that's good. Wanna check I don't, like, miss anything? Okay. Uh-huh. Green line. 1, 2. Sure. That is a bright light. Again, I hope there's not a statue somewhere, because it's all gray to me. Like, I'm never gonna see that if that's here. Oh well. Oh, I hear growling though. Okay. The pig. Oh well, that's pretty funny. I mean, I don't know if it's a joke, like, but it's like, that's a fun detail. And again, even when I'm complaining about bosses and all that, I love the environments. Like, this is so detailed. There's so much good stuff here. It's so immersive, and so creepy, and so creative. Oh man, I love it. I love it so much. Ah, so good, so good, so good. Anything there? Nope. Anything there? I don't think so, no. Wait. Okay, no, okay, good. That, like, blue thing almost looked like shotgun shells, but nope. Okay, good. But, you know, it's good to be... Oh, wait, can I... I can! If it's an explosive, I'm kind of... But it's... I have a save point just there. So, you know, let's just go. Let's just try. Ooh! That's a... Sure. Well, that... I'll give it to you. I wasn't expecting that. That's pretty awesome. Ooh, rain sludge. Okay, so now we go to the creepy ass subways. Oh, wait, that is shotgun shells and brain sludge. Anything else? Nope. Okay, good. Oh, well, you know. Red light, but that's just a fire extinguisher. Okay, good. So, anything. I hear, like, this weird, like, electronic moaning, like, in the very, very faint distance, but I'm not sure if it's, like, just ambient music or... Check the door to the right first before going forward. I got a feeling I just always... Like, wherever I think is the side way, I should maybe... That is a nasty ass, yeah. Oh! And once again we see it is a good idea to sneak forward. I would have been so dead. Ha 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 ha. Well, that's... Well, now we check there too. What about here? Oh! That actually... that wouldn't have fitted into the into the actual place, like, but anyway, that's, but I'm glad I have brain sludge. I'm not complaining. Okay, and we have also some trap parts, good, and another red light, but that's again just a fire extinguisher. Okay, and also I didn't read it out loud, but one of the loading screens did indeed say that the first aid kit fully heals and gives a little bit more of maximum health, which is pretty nice. And I believe I noticed that before, or at least I thought I saw that happen, but I wasn't completely sure. But now I am. I have a pretty good set of like stuff here. Like I have 69 parts, and with a couple of bolts here and there to spare, and a couple of the both healing items. Well, not a whole lot of handgun bullets, but it's something. Not gonna... Oh, right. I know. I just said I would use the Magnum at the Keeper, but I didn't. Well, My stinginess got the better of me, I guess. But I got fine... by fine with the sniper rifle. Okay. So... what next? What will you throw at me next? Checkpoint. That's a good thing to throw. Oh, and that is a save room. I am going into the save room. As I just check this. Yep, nothing. Okay, good. Excellent, excellent, excellent. So, here we are, and... oh! That's a lot of mines. I'm gonna go to the save room before doing that. Yeah, thanks. Yeah, and just to check that there's not bombs or something. Okay. So, note from Myra. My dearest Sebastian. If you've received this letter, then I fear the worst has come to pass. It means that my investigation got too close to the truth. It means that you may never see me again. I'm sorry I kept it from you, but it was to protect you from either the truth or my madness. I've enclosed a copy of my files. I only hope that you never receive them, but if you do, it's up to you to finish what I started. Please, find justice for Lily and for me. I love you with all of my heart, Myra. So there's that. So, you know. So maybe the tragedy was indeed an arson or...
Don't you think you should use your crown jewel?
I actually do, but I saved it up for this one special occasion, you see. But before I do that, I actually should check the... And thank you for opening the door for me. I should check the lockers, because I have two keys, actually. Oh, right, the room bus, and then the one in the... What's the word? Dumbbell? Or, you know, the, like, place in the kitchen. Or the, well, old sort of food left. Ah, that's one. That was exactly what I'm hoping for, if it's a lot. 5,000 is a lot, technically. But I've gotten a lot better, too, from these places, though. Two healing items isn't all that... Oh, well. I mean, it's something, sure. But yeah, now is an excellent time to get my maximum health to full. I'm pretty injured, and I will now, using this, save a healing item. Or actually, well... multiple, even, if I think in syringes, so, you know. So here we go. I hope it's a big improvement, though. It's bigger than the other ones. It's plus 20 when the others were plus 10, so that's something. Okay, 14,000. So what is the next thing I should think of? I still, like, the only part where I was even a little bit winded was the, the thing with the keeper, and even there, only because I was running around a lot, because I was at first expecting that I would have to, like, avoid him. But I didn't, because, yeah. So I still don't think I need that to be full, so that's maybe not something to wait around on. The agony bolts, when I use explosive, that's fine. Don't need more. Well, it's not, like, super expensive, but still. That doesn't feel like a priority. Same goes for this one. And this one. This, I feel, is good enough. This is good enough, like, I can... When I do this, I can now sneak kill up to 3 zombies. I don't need more than that. And, yeah, nah. Like, I know it's burning, but still. I'm almost tempted to get +2 magnum ammo capacity, because I have a lot of them. The other ones, I don't think I'll need. This almost, but it's also pretty expensive to have, like, I just use them. This is what it's supposed to be, yeah, matches. Yeah, I've now run up against the maximum, yes, at one point, but still. Like, if I have 15, I think I'm good. So, I'm not sure what I would... Magnum damage. I think that's the next thing. Because otherwise, I think I'm kind of good. Like, I'm not going to do more accuracy in this. Like, this is like... I would not call this worth it. Like, even this is like... I mean, it's more than nothing. I will agree that. Like, I'm sure that the crosshairs are smaller than they were at the beginning and all that. So I will... Yeah, that's probably true. And the better critical chance. It wasn't, like, expensive to get, but I'm not gonna do more of these. I don't feel like it's, like... It doesn't speak to me, let's say. But this one, because... And at this point, I would then, like, utilize my bullets the most, because I would then have an upgraded amount of damage in all of the bullets I already own. So, let's take this. And, you know what? I hope this is not a mistake, but I feel like +2 magnum ammo, this, just in case I find even more, you know? Because otherwise, I feel like I'm pretty ready to take on almost anything. Like, I feel like I have most of everything that I find in any way important to me, you know? So, why not? Why not? Yeah, health is looking pretty okay. And I believe... If I can just open this, and is there a newspaper? It looks like there might be. There is! Fire at office. Office linked to foreign intelligence burned. Arrests made. Building housing community outreach center burns to the ground. There were allegations the center was a front for foreign intelligence. Huh. How is that, like, linked to all of this? Like, I think all of the other stuff I found have been about the mental hospital, about Ruvik's old home, the mansion, and Castellanos' home, Castellanos' wife, the lost bodies, which were then operated on by Ruvik. But how does this... This is something else. I gotta remember that. That could be important. Who are you? Missing Ivan Diaz, freelance journalist, never returned from covering a story. His camera and notebook were found in the village of Elk River. I'm forgetting. Is Elk River Village the one where... Or is Elk River the village I was in at the very beginning? Or at least, well, the nightmare version of it, but still. I'm not sure, but maybe? I don't think I've seen that person, though. think. Not sure, but I think that's the case. Maybe. Interesting. But I am now all out of time for this episode. Actually, then some. I've gone a bit long, but I will absolutely be continuing this later on. I hope you've enjoyed this. And if you have, please shoot up a like or a comment or even subscribe if it would really help. And thank you so much for watching, and I will see you again next time.